This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the powerful platform to harness your creativity and build a beautiful online presence. Oh. I can explain. And that's what I'm going to be doing here today. Explaining what on earth that was. For me, 2020 was a year full of experimentation. I attempted many new hobbies, tried to learn several new skills, and just started saying yes to more opportunities, all of which I gave up on. One of the hobbies I decided to dip my toes in was becoming a houseplant person. You know, those people in their minimally designed rooms, sipping an iced coffee, spending all day calmly saving images to their numerous Pinterest boards. The kinds of people who refer to these as their babies. This was the goal. Like most things I do, this was an impulsive decision spurred on by nothing more than a few Instagram posts that popped up one afternoon. Actually, to be fair, that's kinda downplaying it. My whole app was full of succulents. Boom, succulents. People's stories. Boom, succulents. The For You page. Boom, succulents. My profile pic. Boom, succulents. I wanted a succulent, but if I was going to become a certified plant mummy, I needed to be responsible. So I did some research. Not about how to keep the plants happy and healthy, about pots. Instead, my little leafy son needed to be snazzy. First, I looked at one of Australia's most well-known general purpose / homeware stores, Kmart. People here love the shop because it just stocks the most random junk.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. I didn't want a boring, ordinary pot, but I didn't want to go overboard and end up with something ugly either. I decided I was after an animal pot, any in particular, just as long as they fit the cute criteria. I found some cute dachshunds and llama ones, but I had a thought. I could buy them online, or I could just wait until the weekend and get one then? Yeah, I might do that. Kmart that weekend. Oh, disappointing. No big deal though, I'll just have to get something online. Kmart back at home.
You've got to be kidding! Where are the cute pots?
I was clearly rushing into my child adoption because after failing to find a cute pot, I completely gave up on the idea. Okay, that's it, bye! That was until I was at my work about to start my shift, and I see...
Let there be light.
Oh my god, it's amazing. The dream was alive again.
How could I say no to this?
After class one day, I figured that on my way home, I could drop into the closest Bunnings warehouse. For all of you non-Aussies, Bunnings warehouse is a god-tier store when it comes to building stuff. It's like a maze in there, filled with nails, wood, outdoor furniture, plants, power tools, little tools, toilets, legit anything that falls under the genre hardware, it's there. People often go there without wanting to buy anything building related, because Bunnings is famous for their in-store sausage sandwich barbecues, which are to die for. The absolute pinnacle of Australian cuisine. Sanger. I finally tracked down the plant section and oh my, my hay fever allergies were not a fan. Hachoo! But there it was, the cutest succulent in the building. As I turned the corner, I saw him standing off in the corner, and despite his shy demeanor, he locked eyes with me. My heart fluttered, and I tucked my hair behind my ear. I couldn't believe I had found the one.
Security!
For just $7-y-do smackaroonies, I got him comfortable in my car for the drive home. This boy even got featured on my Twitter. Aww. Follow me for wholesome moments like this. The drive home was great! Until... Phew, that could have ended badly. And now, Mini Clay Jess would like to tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an amazing platform for building your own websites and solidifying your personal brand. As mentioned in my previous video, I've created my own website with Squarespace called The Wobble.club, where I've been constantly switching up the content and it's been a lot of fun. I've just turned it into a digital sketchbook to show you guys how my videos go from idea to draft, then finally a finished animation. It's a fun behind the scenes look if you're also interested in creating animated videos like me. To do this, I mainly use Squarespace's video block integrations. For someone who makes mostly video content, I really appreciate how convenient these were to apply. Then just as easily, I was able to place image grids in the layout that best suited the page. And once again, I made sure all of my social media platforms were connected with these little cute icons, which were so easy to do, and ta-da! A fully functional JellyJess website. Oh, actually, one other great thing about making a website with Squarespace is that you retain the rights to all your content. They just act as a user-friendly platform to showcase your work with the world. To get started with your own website, head over to squarespace.com for a free trial, and then when you're ready to launch, you can visit squarespace.com/JellyJess to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thanks again to Squarespace for supporting my channel. I highly recommend checking them out. Back to the video. The next day, my mum helped me replace the spilled soil and the succulent itself into the little hedgehog pot. Things were going great until once again, they weren't. Okay, so you just put it in like this.
Crunch. Snap.
Mum, you're literally tearing off the leaves.
What do you mean?
Mum!
No!
I know my dear mother wasn't intentionally trying to squish the absolute life out of it, but she was doing exactly that.
But hey, it's still worth it, right? Oh, how cute.
Since I had all these fallen soldiers, Mum suggested to propagate them. If like me, you didn't know, it means to breed specimens of a plant or animal by natural processes from the parent stock. And the second definition is spread and promote an idea, theory, etc. widely. I'm propagating my merch now, links are below, haha. But yeah, you can cut plants and grow them again, which is some pretty freaky stuff.
La 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 la, little bit of water and sun, that should do it.
Yeah, the Australian heat didn't help them out. Even though they're like the most resilient plant on the planet and like harsh conditions, they burnt to a crisp real quick.
What else could go wrong?
I just wanted a sun!
A lot more went wrong. I didn't overwater it, I gave it different exposures to light here and there, but nothing was going great. He was just persistently sad. Oh yeah, I also put him on a shelf and a light fell directly on him.
He was just persistently sad.
It was starting to turn all brown in colour, and almost all the leaves had fallen off. I came to the realisation that unfortunately, there was no hope in saving him.
I will remember you.
I don't know if it was a sign from the universe, but to my surprise, my goal wasn't gone forever. I actually got gifted another succulent and a cactus on my birthday, and I promise I haven't murdered them. Yet. The succulent's actually already dead.